morning. I hope that you are better on this day. So let's start our topic with a beautiful quote. The ups and downs in a life are also very important to keep us going, because a straight line, even in an ECG, means we are not live more. So today our topic is ECG. We heard this name many times. ECG means electrocardiography, in that electro means electrical activity, cardio means heart, and graphy means visualizations. So it is a graphical representations of a electrical activity of our heart with each beat as electrical impulses travels through our heart. So let's start with the introduction. So William Inthoven is considered as the father of modern ECG. So what is actual ECG or normal ECG look like? So let's see in this video. Okay, so ECG is a kind of painless, non-invasive way to help diagnose many common heart problems like arrhythmias, coronary artery disease, myocardial infarction. You may also need ECG on a symptoms of chest pain, heart palpitation, vertigo and dizziness. Okay, so now what are the ECG placement site? So mostly 12 lead ECG is used in a clinical practice, in that 10 electrodes required to produce 12 lead ECG. So first 4 electrodes on a forelimb that you see on image. That the right arm have a red color code, left arm have a yellow color code, right leg have a black color code, and left leg have a green color code. Then a 6 leads on a chest. So V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, and V6. So let's discuss about placement of chest lead. V1 in the 4th intercostal space, right margin of a sternum. Then V2, the 4th intercostal space, left margin on a sternum. Then V4, 5th intercostal space, mid clavicular line on a left side. Then V3, in the midway between V2 and V4. Then V5, in the 5th intercostal space, anterior axillary line. And V6, at the 5th intercostal space, mid axillary line. So it is about ECG placement for limb lead and 6 chest lead. You have to remember this placement of electrodes. Then there are other electrode system, like 3 electrode system you see in this image, in that use of 3 electrodes that are right arm, and left leg. In that right leg, it should be not used. It monitor display bipolar lead, that is 1, 2 and 3. The other is a 5 electrode system, using a 5 electrodes on right arm, right leg, left arm, left leg and chest. So firstly, seen an overview of a correlation between a conduction system and ECG representation via short video, and then we discuss each component separate.
ECG is a recording heart activity via sensor attached to the skin. So here we learn about basic interpretation of ECG. ECG have P wave, QRS complex and G wave. So first, P wave is produced as electric impulses generated at the SA node and spread to the atrial to make them contract, so it denotes the atrial depolarization. Then SA node transmitted to the AV node and make a flat line on ECG, that is known as PR segment. Then as the impulses transmitted for an bundle of hills, then the Q wave is produced. Then electric impulses transmitted to a ventricular make them contract and form a QRS complex on ECG. So here QRS complex is a larger than P wave, because ventricle is a bigger than an atrium, produce much electrical activity. It represents the ventricular depolarization. QRS complex denotes the ventricular depolarization of ECG. ST segment represents isoelectrical period, and then T wave represents the ventricular repolarization. So it is a normal ECG interpretation.
So here we saw the correlations between the conduction system and ECG representation. So let's see each component separately. So this diagram shows the normal ECG. Here, this one is a P wave. It is a small curve which denotes a P wave. Then this one is a PR interval. So let's see the P wave first. P wave denotes the arterial depolarization. Usually take 0.08 to 0.10 second. Then PR interval, it is a period of time from the onset of P wave to the beginning of QRS complex is termed as a PR interval, which normally range 0.12 to 0.20 second. This interval represents the time between onset of arterial depolarization and the onset of ventricular depolarization. If PR interval is a greater than 0.20 second, there is a condition of AVIC conduction block, which caused as a first degree heart block. Then third component is a PR segment. It is the end of P wave to the onset of QRS complex, serve as an isoelectrical line on a ECG curve. Then QRS complex. So QRS complex represent a ventricular depolarization. Normally duration is about 0.06 to 0.10 second. So QRS complex denote ventricular depolarization. Then ST segment, it is an isoelectrical period following the QRS complex ending and a beginning of a T wave, is a time at which both ventricles are completely depolarized. ST segment is very important in a diagnosis of ventricular ischemia or hypoxia. It takes about 0.005 to 0.15 second. Then T wave. So T wave represent ventricular repolarization. It takes usually 0.10 to 0.25 second. Then QT interval. So QT interval is the range from 0.20 to 0.40 second. QT interval shows onset of depolarization to the completion of repolarization of the ventricle. It measures from a beginning of a QRS complex to the end of T wave.
ECG, normal ECG, its component that are P wave, PR interval, PR segment, then ST segment, QRS complex, T wave and QT interval. And we discuss about the normal duration of each component. In next video, we learn more about ECG interpretation. Thank you. Thank you for watching.